Alright, let's get started with Civil 3D. So first, we need to open Civil 3D. So Civil 3D is basically a vertical product. So the way it works is pretty much they have taken AutoCAD. AutoCAD comes with your AutoCAD LT, which is basically a 2D drafting AutoCAD. And then they got the AutoCAD 3D. And so that's a full version of AutoCAD. And on top, it's like an onion shell. On top, they have wrapped Map3D tools. So pretty much when you buy Map3D, you will get complete functionality of Map3D and 2D and 3D capabilities of AutoCAD. Similarly, when you buy Civil 3D, Civil 3D comes up with Civil 3D tools, Map3D tools, and AutoCAD tools together. And apart from that, Civil 3D also comes with other plugins such as your Subassembly Composer, your Storm and Sandtrain Analysis, and Hydroflow, and Geotech Analysis, Bridge Modeler. You can get a whole lot of additional plugins from the subscription center as well. So this is your package of Civil 3D. So now to get started with your Civil 3D, we first of all, you need to have your ContriKit installed, which helps you to generally get started with a base drawing set with a lot of styles, which is aligned towards the standards that you predominantly follow in your region. So in my region, we use ContriKit called ANZ ContriKit, which is Australia and in New Zealand ContriKit. And to do that, you can go to the start menu and you can type in Civil 3D, and that brings all the Civil 3D icons. You can type in Civil as well. So this is the one I'm going to use, the Civil 3D, Australia and New Zealand. And be watchful, there is also metric version and imperial version. And also we get the Civil 3D AutoCAD vanilla version. So pretty much when you actually open these versions, it actually fires Civil 3D with that particular profile loaded. So there is a Civil 3D ANZ profile and a metric profile and an imperial profile. It just loads those profiles. So I'm going to use the Civil 3D Australia and New Zealand ContriKit. So just click on this icon and wait until Civil 3D loads up on the screen. So first, what we're going to see is we're going to see the basic user interface of Civil 3D. So once you get into this interface, looks exactly same as your AutoCAD interface. So hardly any difference from your Civil 3D. So now, once you get into this interface, if you don't see your Civil 3D tools, you just go to the drop-down menu on the top, which is your quick access toolbar. You can click on it, and then you can click on Civil 3D. So that will load Civil 3D. Okay, let's quickly run through the user interface. The first one is your top left corner. You got your application menu. So when you click on it, you get the typical options where you can open a new file, and you can open an existing file, a save as, export, publish, print, and all these options. On the same panel on the other side, you got an option where you can see all the recently opened files. You can pin some of those drawings in such a case that those drawings will not get lost if you keep opening new files. So rest of the drawings get refreshed. So whichever the new drawings open, it just maintains the new ones. And then you can click on this option to go to AutoCAD options, your standard AutoCAD options, so nothing specific to Civil 3D. And then that's your application menu. Just a little trick on that one. So let's say, for example, if I have a little line, AutoCAD line drawn, and if I try to close my Civil 3D, it is going to give me this prompt saying that you have some unsaved changes and do you want to close your Civil 3D before you want to save it before you close it. So this because, you know, I have drawn something, I haven't saved it, and I'm trying to close Civil 3D. So now if I go back to my application menu, if I double click on that, can you see it brings up the same prompt? So technically it is sort of like a hidden feature where when you double click on this one, it tries to close Civil 3D. So I don't think so many people is too fond of this feature, but some cases when you open a heavy drawing, it takes a while to open it. And if you accidentally double click on this icon, as soon as you open it, it's just going to close it down. So just be watchful of that. Okay, so let's continue with the user interface. So right next to your application menu, you got your quick access toolbar. In the quick access toolbar, you got a whole bunch of tools here. And let's say if you need some specific tools, you can always go and click on this little drop down towards the end of it. So when you click on it, you see all the tools that's already turned on. So you can turn them off as well. And there is a whole bunch of other things that you can turn it on. And if you don't find the tool that you're looking for, you can click on more commands and go and find it from the list. That takes you to the customized user interface. And then you can click on show menu bar, which brings a typical standard AutoCAD menu. And I would suggest for beginners to have this one in the screen, because it generally shows you like a index of a book. It shows you all the tools, all the edit options, everything that is available within your Civil 3D. So pretty much, you know, you get to learn what's all the things that's available in there. So it's just useful. So for this training, I'm just going to turn off the menu bar because we're not going to use it. So then there is an option that says show below the ribbon. So this is for people who have used AutoCAD classic interface. That is like, you know, like around 4 or 5 years ago, we hardly have this sort of interface. People never get used to the ribbon interface. They were still using the classic interface. So this is just a little feature they left it in there for people who really love this classic interface and they want to keep using that. You can go into any of these tools. You can right click and click on add to quick access. So that will add the tools into the quick access toolbar. And if you want to get rid of it, you can go into the tools, right click, and you can say remove from quick access toolbar. So that removes the tool from the quick access toolbar. So now if you want to put it back to the top, you can click on the drop down and then click on show above the ribbon. So which takes a quick access toolbar back into the original location. So you can click on the workspace here. And same way, just in case if you don't have that one there, you can go to the status bar and you can click here and you can change the workspace here as well. And on the right side, we got the info bar. So this is called the info bar. You can click on this little drop down right next to your question mark and you get a whole bunch of tools here. So some of the things that could be really useful is you can go into the tutorials and you can check some of those videos. They're really beautiful. And there is also a whole bunch of video section as well. And this one, which is the discussion groups, takes you to the forum for Civil 3D. So some people always have trouble getting into the right forums because, you know, the Autodesk forums has got forums for each product. And also, say, for example, if it's AutoCAD, there is a forum for AutoCAD, AutoCAD customization for Lisp, for C# and BB customizations. You know, there is a whole bunch of things, whole bunch of forums for even for one particular product. So it always confuses some people. So this one, when you click on it, it will take you to the right forums. And developer resources. So my suggestion is get some of the tools. If you're a developer, there is a separate tutorial. I'm going to do it on the developer side of things, how to build plugins. So when we get there, I'll explain you a bit more. I'll also share some of the resources that I can give it to you guys. So this is basically takes you to the link where it shows some of the documents and reference documents. And about Civil 3D, which takes you to the product details, and you can check what version, what is a build, and sometimes if your Civil 3D is giving trouble, and if you're contacting Autodesk or reseller support, you can capture the screen, you can do a screen grab of this one, and I can send it to the people. So pretty much they can check if it's the latest version, and just in case if it is, if you're wondering how to do an update, you can go into the Autodesk application here, and you can go and check updates for your version of Civil 3D. Easy. And you can click here to manage your license as well. So that's your info bar. And right under that, we got the ribbon interface. So the ribbon interface has got few components. So first one is your tabs. So this will help switch between different tabs. And the tabs has got panels. You see these little separators here. So these are called panels, which you can drag and drop into different locations as well. So the panels has got little drop downs. You can click here and you can see some additional tools, which is going to be really handy. And some of those tools are really advanced, and that's going to help you customize and work on some really crucial things. So my suggestion is get to know your interface. So a lot of people tend to forget these little drop downs here. So it's just useful. And then you can switch on the tabs to actually go between different group of tools. And once you're here, you got the tools up here. The tools has got the little drop-down arrows as well. When you click on it, it shows you all the other options within that particular tool. So easy. So right under that, we got the tool space. So if you are working in Civil 3D interface, you should always have this tool space. So the tool space comes with four tabs: Prospector, Settings, Survey, and Toolbox. So if you wonder, like, where is my tool space? You go to your home tab, you click on this little big button here, and the little buttons here. So the big buttons basically brings the tool space, and these are the tabs. You can turn on and off, and this basically turns on the tabs as well. So typically we have four tabs here. First one is a prospector. So prospector is basically a browser for your drawing data. So whatever the data that you have within your drawing, you can see it in your prospector. At the same time, you can manage the data and you can see if the data is out of date, and also you can create data. You can do all that within the prospector tab. And then if you go to settings, you got whole bunch of settings here. So this is basically like a browser for your drawing styles. So Civil 3D works in a different concept compared to your AutoCAD. Your AutoCAD, basically the concept is you draw anything. So it could be just a basic line, rectangle, whatever the object is. You draw something and you put into a layer and you control the object using the layers. That is a concept of AutoCAD. Whereas within Civil 3D, we have an intermediator. So that's basically called styles. So let's say because you know the point of Civil 3D is we have all intelligent objects. It's a basically intelligent modeling tool. So whenever you build a road or a pipe or an alignment or a profile, anything that you build it, those objects, it's not going to be just a single line. So for example, if it's a pipe, the pipe will have like an outer line, inner lines, and then it will have the circle which goes on both sides of the pipe, which indicates the edges of the pipe. So you know, as you can see, there is bunch of objects that goes together to create one Civil 3D object. So those objects, what happens is they are work as like a single object that is controlled through the style. The style in turn uses your layers within your AutoCAD to control the display of them. So let's say if you want to have a different color for your outside lines of your pipes, you can have a different color. Similarly, each one of those little objects within your main object in Civil 3D, you can configure that into a layer, and then you can configure a different color for them. So that is the reason when you open a blank Civil 3D drawing, and if you go to your layer property screen, you get whole bunch of layers in there. As you can see, the standard blank Civil 3D drawing has got 258 layers, and none of these layers are you created ones. You know, it's not the user created ones. It's all the ones which comes with the Civil 3D template. So that is what we get here. So we will go through those ones a little later on. So now, once we get the tool space in order, so the most important thing is, if you're working in a Civil 3D drawing, don't try to do this auto hide on your tool space to save some space, which is going to prove to be really, really dangerous. The problem with that is your tool space is basically going to give you indication if something is out of date or something is corrupt or something is missing. So if you keep this one auto hide more, your corridor or your profile or any of those objects would have got expired or would have got out of date like some time ago, and you wouldn't even notice, and you continue working on it. So working on out of date data might also corrupt your drawings. So just be watchful and never ever close your tool space while you're working on Civil 3D. So make sure that you always have it in your visible screen. So once the tool space is all set, so then it's your command line. So where you go and type some commands. Unfortunately, Civil 3D doesn't come up with any commands like your AutoCAD. So this looks sort of more like Revit. In Revit, you don't have a command line. So pretty much you go by the ribbon. So that's the same concept Autodesk is implementing into Civil 3D. Pretty much you go to your ribbon, you click on the tools, and ribbon is going to help you design everything. So we still have few commands that we will go into AutoCAD command line, and we will see that in future classes. So next is your drawing space, which is your model space, and your layout, which is your paper space where you go and print it, and your status bar, which has got a whole bunch of tools in here. You know, it's just a standard AutoCAD tools. And one important thing is, in Civil 3D, even though it is a 3D modeling tool, and in your model space, you don't rotate things. So there is a separate view that is called Object Viewer. So generally, you select the objects that you want to see it in 3D, and you take it to your Object Viewer, which is much faster and less cluttered, and it works seamlessly. So it's much better to work in that space. So if you want to check something in 3D, you always select the object and go to Object Viewer. So that's all the basics about the user interface of Civil 3D, and catch you up in the next lesson. Thanks, guys.